IPPF has reached a remarkable turning point in our 67-year history. We have moved from crisis to a groundswell of support for positive change. By coming together, our member associations have made change happen. This is the story of the IPPF General Assembly 2019.
I take this opportunity to welcome you to my motherland, India.
329 delegates from 123 of our member associations came together in New Delhi, India.
This wonderful city where so much of IPPF's history has been written and will be written again.
Their task, to debate reforms to IPPF proposed by two independent commissions.
We are looking at our governance system and our fund allocation, and we are trying to find a way to be more productive, more agile, and more efficient.
Voices from all over the world expressed their hopes, fears, and suggestions.
IPPF needs to reform because we cannot afford to be a heavy-set organization.
We need to see more of youth participation in all the aspects of the IPPF program.
We are changing by choice.
We want to see an organization that is accountable, transparent, and that is leading in sexual rights and reproductive rights.
The world is changing. Young persons are changing. Technology, healthcare is changing, and we need to adapt.
The General Assembly was launched with a youth forum.
We are going to reform IPPF, but part of the reform has to be about youth.
101 young representatives, activists and volunteers came together to discuss their role in the change.
We are not only the future, we're the now, and as young persons we deserve to be heard.
I seek to ensure that the sexual reproductive health and rights of young people are met.
We got the chance to speak up and we got the chance to hear others' opinion about the reform.
We are really changing the Federation for the better. We are changing by choice, for choice, but also for young people.
Over 2 days, delegates debated the governance structure and resource allocation model of IPPF.
Change is scary. Change can be scary, but change is necessary.
Comes a point when people begin to think, how do we come together? And there started to be an articulation from delegates that they didn't really want to be split apart by votes. So then people begin to focus on, what can I live with? And there was a strong momentum for coming together around solutions.
On Saturday, 30th November 2019, member associations reached unanimous consensus on the reforms.
Do I hear consensus?
Consensus shows unification, solidarity. It shows that the things that we agree on are much greater and bigger than the things that we may disagree on.
The Governing Council gave their approval.
We fully endorse the report you shared with us.
We can now rebuild IPPF so that it can meet the challenges of the 21st century.
We are changing, and in doing so, we have changed the course of history. And this has been done through you.
I feel happy, elated, exhausted, very emotional. I cannot wait to go back to what really matters for us, which is to be at the forefront of our service delivery work and our advocacy for sexual reproductive health and rights.
I feel so proud of what we've achieved together and so proud about what we can achieve for the people that we serve.
I think this is a historical moment for IPPF and a way to look at a bright future for a stronger organization.
I feel so great because we are taking a huge step towards the future. So it's amazing for us as young people.